Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the One Word series where we discuss the impact of a single word on a verse of the Quran. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the story of Nuh alayhi salam. Now the story of Nuh alayhi salam goes that he spent years and years with his people trying to convey to them the message of Islam. And in this one conversation that he's having with the leaders of his people, the leaders are saying, Nuh, you are trying to mislead everyone. You are misguiding everyone. And Nuh alayhi salam, what is his response? He says, "Ubalighukum risalati Rabbi." All I am doing is conveying to you the messages of my master. Wa ansahu lakum, and I am advising you. Now what's interesting is that usually ansahu is translated as advice, or nasiha is translated as advice. Now what's interesting in the Quran is that there are many words for advice, and nasiha or ansahu, it actually refers to one type of advice, and that is that it emphasizes the quality of sincere advice. Nasiha was actually used to describe honey in the past. The ancient Arabs would use the word nasiha to describe honey that is clean and pure, that has no dirtiness or anything, no impurities inside of it. And so that is what the word nasiha was used for. Now, here when it's used in conversation, it means that someone is giving advice sincerely with no other ulterior motives. When the prophets, alayhi wasalam, may Allah give them peace, these prophets, when they would call their people to Islam, they would be sincere. They would not want wealth or status or position. When the Quraysh, they came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, when he was trying to convey to them the message of Islam, what they would do is they would offer the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, they told him, we will make you the king of Mecca. We will give you wealth beyond compare. No one will have as much wealth as you. We will allow you to marry anyone you want in the town of Mecca, in the city of Mecca. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, of course he refused. Because that wasn't his motivation in wanting to convey the message of Islam. He was sincerely giving them advice. And that is how all the prophets were. And so if we ever are put into a position where we are giving advice to someone and someone trusts us, we shouldn't be like a salesman who has an ulterior motive and has some conflict of interest in trying to get that person to go in a certain direction. But rather we should give them sincere advice, advice that is best for them. And so I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He helps us to be sincere and genuine towards others. Jazakumullahu khairan, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.